This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Robert Joseph Bob Dole, born July 22, 1923, is an American politician who represented Kansas in the House of Representatives from 1961 to 1969 and in the United States Senate from 1969 to 1996, serving as Senate Republican leader from 1985 until his resignation as a senator in the 1976 presidential election. Dole was the Republican Party nominee for vice president and incumbent President Gerald Ford's running mate. He ran unsuccessfully for the Republican presidential nomination in 1980 and 1988. In 1996, Dole secured the Republican nomination for President of the United States, but lost the general election to incumbent President Bill Clinton. Dole is currently a member of the Advisory Council of the Victims of Communism Memorial Foundation and Special Counsel at the Washington, D.C., office of law firm Alston. 41 1996 presidential campaign 5 post political career 6 awards 61 military 62 other 7 personal life 71 recent health 8 electoral history 9 see also 10 notes 11 references 12 external links early life and education. Dole was born on July 22, 1923, in Russell, Kansas, the son of Bina M. Ney Talbot, 1904-1983 and Doran Ray Dole, 1901-1975. Dole's father, who had moved the family to Russell shortly before Robert was born, earned money by running a small creamery. One of Dole's father's customers was the father of future Senator Arlen Specter during the Great Depression, which severely impacted Kansas and its residents. The Dole family moved to the basement of their home and eventually rented out the upper floors to raise money. As a boy, Dole worked as a soda jerk in the local drug store. Dole graduated from Russell High School in the spring of 1941 and enrolled at the University of Kansas the following fall. Dole had been a star high school athlete in Russell, and Kansas basketball coach Fog Allen traveled to Russell to recruit him to play for the Jayhawks basketball team. While at KU, Dole played for the basketball team, the track team, and the football team. In football, Dole played at the end position, earning varsity letters in 1942 and 1944. While in college, Dole joined the Kappa Sigma fraternity, and in 1970 was bestowed with the fraternity's Man of the Year honor. Dole's pre-med studies at KU were interrupted by World War II. After the war, Dole returned to become a law student. Dole attended the University of Arizona from 1948 to 1951 and earned both his law degree and BA degrees from Washburn University in 1952. Dole was initiated as a Freemason of Russell Lodge No. 177, Russell, Kansas on April 19, 1955. Dole grew up in a house at 1035 North Maple in Russell, and it remained his official residence throughout his political career. World War II and recovery. In 1942, Dole joined the United States Army's Enlisted Reserve Corps to fight in World War II, becoming a second lieutenant in the Army's 10th Mountain Division in April 1945, while engaged in combat near Castel D'Aiano in the Apennine Mountains southwest of Bologna, Italy. Dole was badly wounded by German machine gun fire, being hit in his upper back and right arm, as Lee Sandlin describes. When fellow soldiers saw the extent of his injuries, all they thought they could do was to give him the largest dose of morphine they dared and write an M for morphine on his forehead in his own blood, so that nobody else who found him would give him a second, fatal dose. Dole was transported to the United States, where his recovery was slow, interrupted by blood clots and a life-threatening infection after large doses of penicillin had not succeeded. Dole overcame the infection with the administration of streptomycin, which at the time was still an experimental drug. He nevertheless remained despondent, not ready to accept the fact that my life would be changed forever. He was encouraged to see a Chicago orthopedist by the name of Hampar Kalikian, who had been working with veterans returning from war. Although during their first meeting Kalikian told Dole that he would never be able to recover fully, the encounter changed Dole's outlook on life, who years later wrote that Kalikian, a survivor of the Armenian Genocide, inspired me to focus on what I had left and what I could do with it, rather than complaining what had been lost. Dr. K, as Dole later came to affectionately call him, operated on him 7 times, free of charge, and had, in Dole's words, an impact on my life second only to my family. Dole recovered from his wounds at the Percy Jones Army Hospital. This complex of federal buildings, no longer a hospital, is now named Hart Dole Inouye Federal Center in honor of three patients who became United States Senators. Dole, Philip Hart and Daniel Inouye Dole was decorated three times, receiving two Purple Hearts for his injuries, and the Bronze Star with Combat V for valor for his attempt to assist a downed radioman political career. Dole ran for office for the first time in 1950 and was elected to the Kansas House of Representatives, serving a two-year term after graduating from law school at Washburn University in Topeka. Dole was admitted to the bar and commenced the practice of law in his hometown of Russell in 1952. Also in 1952, Dole became the county attorney of Russell County, serving in that position for 8 years in 1960. Dole was elected to the United States House of Representatives from Kansas's 6th Congressional District, located in central Kansas in 1962. His district was merged with the 3rd District in western Kansas to form the 1st Congressional District, a huge 60-county district that soon became known as the Big First. Dole was re-elected that year and twice thereafter without serious difficulty. U.S. Senate. A photo taken by Oliver F. Atkins of Bob Dole meeting President Nixon in 1971. In 1968, Dole defeated Kansas Governor William H. Avery for the Republican nomination for the United States Senate to succeed retiring Senator Frank Carlson. Subsequently being elected, Dole was re-elected in 1974, 1980, 1986, and 1992, before resigning on June 12, 1996. To focus on his presidential campaign, Dole faced only one truly enthusiastic and well-financed challenger, Congressman Bill Roy, in 1974. Much of Roy's popularity was in response to the fallout from Watergate. Dole would win re-election in 1974 by only a few thousand votes, having in the end graphically painted Roy as pro-abortion. While in the Senate, Dole served as chairman of the Republican National Committee from 1971 until 1973, the ranking Republican on the Agriculture Committee from 1975 to 1978, and the ranking Republican on the Finance Committee from 1979 to 1980. Dole in Emporia, Kansas, 1974. Photo by Patricia DuBose Duncan. When the Republicans took control of the Senate after the 1980 elections, Dole became chairman of the Finance Committee in 1981, serving until 1985. From 1985, when Howard Baker of Tennessee retired, until his resignation from the Senate, Dole was the leader of the Senate Republicans, serving as majority leader from 1985 until 1987 and again from 1995 to 1996. Dole served as minority leader from 1987 to 1995 following the advice of conservative William Kristol. Dole flatly rejected the health care plan of Bill Clinton, remarking, "There is no crisis in health care." Dole had a moderate voting record and was widely considered to be one of the few Kansas Republicans who could bridge the gap between the moderate and conservative wings of the Kansas Republican Party. As a congressman in the early 1960s, Dole supported the major civil rights bills, which appealed to moderates when Johnson proposed the Great Society in 1964-65. Dole voted against some war on poverty measures like public housing subsidies and Medicare, thus appealing to conservatives. Dole's first speech in the Senate in 1969 was a plea for federal aid for the handicapped. Later, as a member of the Senate Select Committee on Nutrition and Human Needs, Dole joined Liberal Senator George McGovern to lower eligibility requirements for federal food stamps, a liberal goal that was supported by Kansas farmers. Dole's hawkishness on the Vietnam War and on crime issues kept him in good standing with the right wing when they heard Nixon might make Dole chairman of the Republican National Committee. Half the Republican senators protested, especially moderates who feared Dole would direct party assets to conservatives. Presidential politics. Bob Dole, far left at the 1976 Republican National Convention in Kansas City with from left Nancy Reagan, Ronald Reagan, President Gerald Ford, Vice President Nelson Rockefeller, Susan Ford and Betty Ford. During 1988 primaries, Dole won Iowa, Minnesota, South Dakota, Wyoming and home state Kansas. However, recovered in time to defeat Dole in the New Hampshire primary a week later. The New Hampshire contest between the two was particularly bitter, although they differed little on the issues after the returns had come in on the night of that primary. Dole appeared to lose his temper in a television interview. Dole was interviewed live in New Hampshire on NBC by Tom Brokaw, who was in the NBC studio in New York. It happened that Bush was right next to Brokaw in the studio. Brokaw asked Bush if he had anything to say to Dole. Bush responded, "No, just wish him well and meet again in the South, Dole, apparently not expecting to see Bush, when asked the same question about the vice president said, yeah, stop lying about my record, largely in response to a very tough New Hampshire Bush commercial which accused Dole of straddling on taxes. This remark prompted some members of the media to perceive him as angry about the loss, contributing to Dole's hatchet man image earned during his tenure as RNC chairman and the 76 campaign despite two big wins in South Dakota and Minnesota a week after New Hampshire. Dole was not able to recover, viewed by many as a micromanager who could not effectively oversee a presidential campaign while serving as a senator. Dole did not hire a full-time campaign manager, former Tennessee Senator Bill Brock, until late 1987, well after Bush's team had been in place despite raising almost as much money as the Bush campaign. The Dole campaign spent its money faster and was vastly outspent in the contests held after Iowa. New Hampshire, Minnesota, and South Dakota, despite a key endorsement by Senator Strom Thurmond, one of many Republican senators who supported their leader. Dole was defeated by Bush again in South Carolina in early March several days later. Every southern state voted for Bush in a Super Tuesday sweep. Another big loss in Illinois persuaded Dole to withdraw from the race. 1996 presidential campaign election results by county. Despite the willingness of other Republicans to continue the shutdown unless their demands were met, in particular, as Gingrich and Dole had been seen as potential rivals for the 1996 presidential nomination, they had a tense working relationship. The shutdown was cited as having a role in Clinton's successful 1996 re-election by Clinton aide George Stephanopoulos. The popularity of the incumbent president, Bill Clinton, had improved greatly from 1994 to 1996 thanks to a booming economy as well as winning public opinion in the 1995 budget shutdown, so Clinton and Vice President Al Gore faced no serious opposition in the Democrat primaries a few months before his passing in April 1994. Richard Nixon warned Dole, "If the economy's good, you're not going to beat Clinton." Dole was the early front runner for the GOP nomination in the 1996 presidential race. At least 8 candidates ran for the nomination. Dole was expected to win the nomination against underdog candidates such as the more conservative Senator Phil Gramm of Texas and more moderate Senator Arlen Specter of Pennsylvania. Pat Buchanan upset Dole in the early New Hampshire primary, however, with Dole finishing second and former Tennessee Governor Lamar Alexander finishing third. Speechwriter Kerry Timchuk remarked, "Dole was on the ropes because he wasn't conservative enough." Publisher Steve Forbes also ran and broadcast a stream of negative ads. Dole ending up had been forced to spend more on the primary than he had planned, and until the convention in San Diego faced federal limits on campaign spending. Dole eventually won the nomination, becoming the oldest first-time presidential nominee at the age of 73 years, 1 month. Ronald Reagan was 73 years, 6 months in 1984. For his second presidential nomination, Dole found the initial draft of the acceptance speech written by Mark Halperin as too hard-line, so Kerry Timchuk, who was part of the "Let Dole Be Dole" crowd, revised the speech to cover the themes of honor, decency and straight talk, and why it included the following line, a swat at the all-or-nothing rookie Republicans who had been swept into Congress in the 1994 midterm GOP wave. "In politics, honorable compromise is no sin. It is what protects us from absolutism and intolerance." In his acceptance speech, Dole stated, "Let me be the bridge to an America that only the unknowing call myth. Let me be the bridge to a time of tranquility, faith, and confidence in action." To which incumbent President Bill Clinton responded, "We do not need to build a bridge to the past. We need to build a bridge to the future." Dole was the first sitting Senate party leader to receive his party's nomination for president. Dole hoped to use his long experience in Senate procedures to maximize publicity from his rare positioning as Senate Majority Leader against an incumbent president, but was stymied by Senate Democrats on June 11, 1996. Dole resigned his seat to focus on the campaign, saying he was either heading for the White House or home. As told in the Dole's joint biography, Unlimited Partners, speechwriter and biographer Kerry Timchuk wrote that he was going to make a statement. He was going to risk it all for the White House. He knew his time as leader was over. It would have been tough to come back if he lost in November. He knew it was time to move up or move out. Dole promised a 15% across-the-board reduction in income tax rates and made former congressman and supply-side advocate Jack Kemp his running mate for vice president. Dole found himself criticized from both the left and the right within the Republican Party over the convention platform, one of the major issues being the inclusion of the Human Life Amendment. Clinton framed the narrative against Dole early, painting him as a mere clone of unpopular then-House Speaker Newt Gingrich, warning America that Dole would work in concert with the Republican Congress to slide Dole/popular social programs, like Medicare and Social Security, dubbed by Clinton as Dole Gingrich. Dole's tax cut plan found itself under attack from the White House, who said it would blow a hole in the deficit with the infancy of the Internet. Dole Kemp was the first presidential campaign to set up a website, edging out Clinton Gore, which was set up by Arizona State College students Rob Cabasco and Vince Salvato. The concerns over Dole's age and lagging campaign were exemplified by a memorable incident on September 18, 1996 at a rally in Chico, California. Dole was reaching down to shake the hand of a supporter, when the railing on the stage gave way and he tumbled 4 feet. While Dole suffered only minor injuries in the fall, the televised image of his painful grimace underscored the age difference between him and Clinton and proved an ominous sign for Republican hopes of retaking the White House during the latter half of October 1996. Dole made a campaign appearance with Heather Whitestone, the first deaf Miss America, where both of them signed "I Love You" to the crowd around that time. Dole and his advisors knew that they would lose the election, but in the last 4 days of the campaign they went on the 96-hour victory tour to help Republican congressional candidates. Dole was defeated, as pundits had long expected, by Bill Clinton in the 1996 election. Clinton won in a 379-159 Electoral College landslide, capturing 492% of the vote against Dole's 407% and Ross Perot's 84%. In his election night concession speech, Dole remarked, "I was thinking on the way down in the elevator, tomorrow will be the first time in my life I don't have anything to do." Dole later wrote, "I was wrong 72 hours after conceding the election. I was swapping wisecracks with David Letterman on his late night show." Dole is the only person in the history of the two major U.S. political parties to have been a party's nominee for both president and vice president, but who was never elected to either office. It is a virtual reversal to the situation of his former running mate Gerald R. Ford, who had served both as vice president and as president without being elected to either office. The span of 20 years between his participation in the 1976 vice presidential debate and the 1996 presidential debates is the longest for any candidate since televised debates in presidential election years were instituted in 1960. Dole is the last World War II veteran to have been the presidential nominee of a major party during the campaign. Dole's advanced age was brought up, with critics stating that he was too old to be president. However, Dole has lived past January 20, 2005, the date he would have completed 2 terms as president had he won in 1996 and re-elected in 2000. Post-political career 2005, Dole speaking at the 60th anniversary of Vey Day, the 1996 presidential election, despite ending in a loss, opened up numerous opportunities for Dole, owing in part to his sense of humor. Dole has engaged in a career of writing, consulting, public speaking, and television appearances. Dole became a television commercial spokesman for such products as Viagra, Visa, Dunkin' Donuts, and Pepsi Cola with Britney Spears, and as an occasional political commentator on the interview program Larry King Live, and has been a guest a number of times on Comedy Central's satirical news program, The Daily Show with Jon Stewart. Dole was, for a short time, a commentator opposite Bill Clinton on CBS's 60 Minutes. Dole guest starred as himself on NBC's Brooke Shields sitcom Suddenly Susan in January 1997. Shortly after losing the presidential election, Dole also made a cameo appearance on Saturday Night Live, parodying himself in November 1996. Dole joined the Washington, D.C., law firm of Alston Nutritious Meals to Children in Schools in Developing Countries. This internationally popular program would go on to provide more than 22 million meals to children in 41 countries in its first 8 years. It has since led to greatly increased global interest in and support for school feeding programs. In 2007, President George W. Bush appointed Dole and Donna Shalala, former Secretary of Health and Human Services, as co-chairs of the commission to investigate problems at Walter Reed Army Medical Center. In 2007, Dole joined fellow former Senate Majority Leaders Howard Baker, Tom Daschle, and George Mitchell to found the Bipartisan Policy Center, a nonprofit think tank that works to develop policies suitable for bipartisan support. That same year, President George W. Bush appointed Dole and Donna Shalala co-chairs of the President's Commission on Care for America's Returning Wounded Warriors to investigate problems at Walter Reed Army Medical Center. Dole appears in the 2008 documentary on Lee Atwater, Boogie Man, the Lee Atwater story in the film. Dole says, "I don't comment on Atwater. Additionally, this isn't politics, this is garbage." On January 26, 2012, Dole issued a letter critical of Newt Gingrich, focusing on Dole and Gingrich's time working together on Capitol Hill. The letter was issued immediately before the Florida primary. Dole endorsed Mitt Romney for the Republican nomination on December 4, 2012. Dole made an appearance on the Senate floor to advocate ratification of the Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities. Democratic Senator John Kerry explained, "Bob Dole is here because he wants to know that other countries will come to treat the disabled as we do." The Senate rejected the treaty by a vote of 61-38, less than the 66 required for ratification. Many Republican senators voted against the bill, fearing it would impact American sovereignty. In early 2014, Dole began a reunion tour to his home state of Kansas, in which he sought to visit each of the state's 105 counties. At each stop, he spends approximately an hour speaking with old friends and well-wishers. Dole endorsed and campaigned for Senator Pat Roberts during the latter's 2014 re-election bid. In 2015, Dole endorsed former Florida Governor Jeb Bush in his presidential campaign after Bush ended his campaign following the South Carolina primary. Dole endorsed Florida Senator Marco Rubio's campaign during the campaign. Dole criticized Ted Cruz and his anti-government stance, calling him an extreme conservative and rhino. Dole endorsed Donald Trump after the latter clinched the Republican nomination, and Dole was the lone former Republican presidential nominee to attend the 2016 Republican National Convention. Dole had attended every GOP convention since 1964, and did not consider skipping the 2016 edition, even though Trump's politics were closer to that of Dole's 1996 primary rival Pat Buchanan. Former Dole advisors, including Paul Manafort, play a major role in Trump's presidential campaign. In February 2016, Dole donated $20,000 to help pay for a camp for children with cancer in Central Kansas. Awards Military Bronze Star Medal, Purple Heart with Oak Leaf Cluster, American Campaign Medal, European African Middle Eastern Campaign Medal, World War II Victory Medal. Other. On January 18, 1989, Dole was presented with the Presidential Citizens Medal by President Reagan. On January 17, 1997, Senator Dole was presented the Presidential Medal of Freedom by President Bill Clinton for his service in the military and his political career. In his acceptance remarks in the East Room of the White House, Dole remarked, "I had a dream that I would be here this historic week receiving something from the president, but I thought it would be the front door key." In 1997, Dole received the U.S. Senator John Hines Award for Greatest Public Service by an elected or appointed official, an award given out annually by Jefferson Awards. In October 2001, Dole received the Gold Good Citizenship Award from the National Society of the Sons of the American Revolution. Dole received the American Patriot Award in 2004 for his lifelong dedication to America and his service in World War. Dole is a Freemason and a member of Russell Lodge No. 177, Russell, Kansas. In 1975, Dole was elevated to the 33rd degree of the Scottish Rite. Dole often refers to himself in the third person in conversation. Recent health. In 2001, Dole, at age 77, was treated successfully for an abdominal aortic aneurysm by vascular surgeon Kenneth Oriel. Dr. Oriel said Dole maintained his sense of humor throughout his care. In recent years, Dole has struggled with health problems. In December 2004, he had a hip replacement operation which required him to receive blood thinners 1 month after the surgery. It was determined that Dole was bleeding inside his head. Dole spent 40 days at Walter Reed, and upon release, his good arm, the left, was of limited use. Dole told a reporter that he needed help to handle the simplest of tasks. Since both of his arms are injured, Dole undergoes physical therapy for his left shoulder once a week, but doctors have told him that he might not regain total use of his left arm. In 2009, Dole was hospitalized for an elevated heart rate and sore legs, for which he underwent a successful skin graft procedure. In February 2010, Dole was hospitalized for pneumonia after undergoing knee surgery. He spent 10 months at Walter Reed, recovering from the surgery, and experienced 3 bouts with pneumonia. Dole was released from the hospital in November 2010. In January 2011, however, Dole was readmitted to Walter Reed Hospital and spent about 6 days there, being treated for a fever as well as a minor infection. Dole was hospitalized in the latter part November 2012, at Walter Reed Army Medical Center. According to Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid. Electoral History. Main article, Electoral History of Bob Dole. See also Biography. Portal. Politics. Portal. United States Army. Portal. Kemp Commission. Notable Freemasons. Notes. Carrot. Frontline. The Choice. 96, Stories of Bob, PBS. Retrieved June 17, 2010. ISBN 1996 Bob Dole acceptance speech, Portland Publishing House. Com retrieved June 17, 2010. Presidential election exit poll results, Part 1. CNN retrieved April 26, 2010. Clinton School Speakers retrieved June 17, 2010. Nia Malika Henderson October 2, 2014 Pat Roberts unleashes his secret weapon, Bob Dole, Washington Post. And Principal by NCAGC, Armenian Weekly retrieved 5 March 2016. Bob Dole hospitalized, ABC News retrieved November 28, 2012. Speaking from the heart, Westport, Prager ISBN. Wynn Smith, member of the U.S. House of Representatives from Kansas's 6th Congressional District 1961-1963 constituency abolished, proceeded. From Kansas Class 3 1968, 1974, 1980, 1986, 1992 succeeded. Howard Baker, Senate Republican leader 1985-1996 succeeded. Served alongside, James Pearson, Nancy Kassebaum succeeded. Senate Minority Leader 1987-1995 succeeded. VE United States Senators from Kansas Class 2 Lane Ross Caldwell Crozier Harvey Plum Perkins Martin Baker Burton Benson Curtis Thompson Capper. Schopel Pearson Kassebaum Roberts Class 3 Pomeroy Ingalls Peffer Harris Long Bristow Curtis Allen McGill Reed Darby Carlson Dole.